Now, we were at Soko Falls, and it's a beautiful place. Of course, I had to bring you along. And we talked about our true identity. We're at Cafe 49 Restaurant in Jinja. Gotcha!
Finally, we are living in our identity.
Oh, gorgeous people, welcome back to my channel. Guys, thank you, as I already said. Thank you for watching, for subscribing. You guys, the last video. And you know what? We hit 200 subscribers. I mean, guys, Friends, thank you so much. I literally have no words. Yes, thank you. We are taking the gospel to another level. Again, thank you. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you for everything. Thank you for your support. I'm honestly here and I'm doing it, and this is our time. Guys, so we went to Soko, me and my girls. Yeah, so of course I brought you guys along. I want to show you that before that, I feel like I need to share something that was in my heart. And we're talking about our true identity. Again, true identity. And this is what I have to say. First of all, my revelation, prayed about it, did my research, and I'm blessed. I know you'll be blessed too, and he'll bless you with yours. But watch and tell that person to watch. Now, our true identity, as you know, the soul of a man will always search for a belonging. Because the soul of a man will search for where to belong, where to identify with. That's why people identify themselves with the tribe, with culture, with religion, with families, and that's their pride. And guys, people will die for these things. Like, someone will literally kill you for offending their culture, because this is where their soul is partly satisfied. But listen, child of God, before all these things, you are a child of God. I mean, the Bible says in Romans 1:16, the Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are children of God. This is the Spirit of God confirming to me that I am a child of God. Before all these things, yes, I'm not against culture, guys. I am a Mugisu, Mulembe Bayaya, Mulembe Mamai, Westminster. I'm a Mugisu for the greeting, and I'm proud of it. I'm proud of being Ugandan. I'm proud of my color. I'm proud of my skin color. Yeah, I love being Malay. I'm proud of everything. But before that, I do not forget that I am a child of God. I am a citizen of heaven, sent on earth as a Mugisu, as a Ugandan, and to the schools I went to execute my mandate on earth. God chose me to come that way because he knew that when I can do whatever I was meant to do. So before all this, before the schools I went to, before my family, before all this, I identify myself as a child of God. We were begotten in this family by Christ, who was the firstborn. How? Let me read for you. And this is in Colossians 1:15, which says, now he is the exact likeness of the unseen God, the invisible representation of the invisible. He is the firstborn of all creation. Listen, when Adam fell, man was separated from God because of sin, because God cannot stand sin. And because of that, the lamb used to be sacrificed by high priests. The blood of the lamb used to cover the sin of man. It didn't wash it away, but it covered it. Get, because a lamb in the spiritual realm, it represents purity, it represents perfection. So God searched the earth and heaven for someone who could take up that role to come and be the perfect lamb, and found no one other than Christ, who is himself, because God and Christ are one. So because of that, God came to earth as man, and he lived like us. He was wounded for transgression, he was beaten, was put to shame, just like me and you can be fine. When he died, his blood was shed and became the perfect lamb, and became the firstborn of all of us, and were begotten in this family, and became the sons of God. We are heirs with him, became the righteousness of God. And because of this puts us ahead of anyone. And because we need this humbles us, making us proud again. Because he says, as it is, so are we. He gave us this exact power that he has get. We are priests, we are royal priests get. This sets us ahead of anyone. Like we are ahead of any human race. So this is where we should get our identity. This is where we should acknowledge and know our identity. And this is what brings us pride. This is what makes us happy than all these things. Again, I said I am proud of who I am. I'm proud of being made Ugandan. God chose me Ugandan and all this. But before that, I am a child of God. And because Christ died and was risen, I was begotten into his family. I have all the authority and power to reign in this earth because I am a child of God. Now, you know what, guys? Let's go to Psalm. Thank you.